Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. I am a brother, royal priest. I am so glad to meet you through this video. I believe that you are fine and blessed. I am too fine and blessed here. So in this video, we are going to see about source of sin. As we know, as a saint, as a believer, we know we are righteous. We are very righteous of God. We are righteous of God. We are righteous people. But still, sometimes we fall in sin. Sometimes we get deceived by Satan. Sometimes we get apart from the word. We get sometimes fall in sin. So today in this video we are going to see about what is the source of sin. If you read from the Bible, Satan always uses these three sources of sin. He always uses three methods to deceive and fall into sin. He has no any new method. He has no any new techniques. He has no any new way to deceive us. He only has primarily three ways or three. Three sources or three ways to deceive us and to make us fall in sin. We are going to see what are those three ways. It doesn't have any new way. I always use these three things only. So if we get to know about the source of sin, so next time we will not fall in sin. We will be aware of the truth and we will be get away from the sin. So this is the main motive of the video. Yeah, before going to the video. Subscribe to the channel, light up post and tap the bell icon. I will be posting 4 videos a week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Let's go into the video. So as I said, there are 3 sources of sin. If we read in the epistle of 1 John, as John was talking about John, the apostle of John, or we can say the apostle of love, he was talking about the sin and walking in the light of the word, and he was talking about the people who don't sin are walking in the light, people who sin are walking in the dark. So he was talking about those things. So when he was talking about those sin, he said something very interestingly. It's in the first epistle of John, chapter 2, verse 16-17. Here he says that, first epistle of John, chapter 2, verse 16-17, he says that, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. So here we see three things. For all that is in the world, first, the lust of the world, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but of the world. So these are the three sources of sin which Satan always uses to deceive us and to push into the sin. So if we define it, what is the lust of flesh? What lust of flesh? So when we say, talk about lust of flesh, always come only about sexual sin. So, even that are true, but only that are not only are not those only the lust of flesh. Whatever comes of flesh, it is sin. If we see in Galatians 5 verse 10 20-21. We'll go to that verse. Galatians chapter 5. Yeah, okay. Galatians chapter 5 verse 19-20-21. It says that now the works of flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envying, murder, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of which I tell you before. So we see saying that the works of flesh, we can even say the lust of flesh. There are total 17 works of flesh. Even the anger comes in the lust of flesh only. Even the murder sin comes in the lust of flesh. So I'm saying not only sexual sins are lust of flesh, even these things are lust of flesh. Or even the works of flesh. So now we will define lust of eyes. What I define lust of eyes is that when we do something, it is just because it is pleasant for it to look. Even we decide doing something against the word of God, just because it's very soothing to our eyes, just because it's very pleasant to our eyes, it's called lust of life eyes. So and next is pride of life. I define pride of life as trying to live a life or doing something which is self-boasting and self-glorifying rather than glorifying Christ and glorifying his name. The simple pride of life means doing something or living a life which is self-posing and self-glorifying rather than glorifying Christ and His name. This is called what is pride of life. Now we will go to the book of beginnings. I always say that if you go to the book of beginnings, we always get a clear picture of what is actually happening. So we go to the book of beginnings, there you will see how did Satan deceive the Adam and Eve. Use the same these three tricks to deceive them. Go to the book of that is Genesis. Book of Genesis chapter 3 verse 6. So before I will say this small intro, you know that serpents God said that don't eat those fruits, but Satan comes and deceives them and saying that by saying that you will not die if you eat this fruit, you will be getting power like God. So you see deceives them by saying those things. After that the sixth verse says that, and when the woman saw that tree, even we can see that when the woman saw in what way the woman saw that tree, or we can say that in what way did Satan show that tree to the woman. Now we'll read that this way as like that, and woman and Satan showed the woman that tree in three things. We'll see that, we'll notice good, so for the tree, the tree was good for food, lust of flesh, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, lust of eyes, she took and the tree to be desired to make one wise. Means she is making I will be wise, I will be like God. It means pride of life, it is self glorifying life. So these are the three source of sin. I will repeat it once again. The saw that the tree that was good for food, in the lust of flesh, the tree and the pleasant to eyes, lust of eyes, tree to be desired to make one wise, pride of life. See, as you are seeing that John says three sources of sin: lust of flesh, lust of eyes, pride of life. Those are the three things. Those are the same three things Satan used to deceive Adam and Eve. As you see, good for food, lust of flesh, pride the pleasant to eyes, lust of eyes, and tree one desire to be made unwise. In which pride of life. These are the three primary things Satan always uses to deceive you. So now we are going to see. Now maybe we saw that Satan uses these three sources of sin to deceive us. So now we are going to see how we are going to get out of this. How we are going to defend. How we are going to defend those temptations. Now we will go to the temptation of Jesus. Now we will go to the Gospel of Luke chapter 4 verse 1 to 13. There we will see that we know Satan was tempted. Satan tempted Jesus. Yeah, absolutely sorry for this. Satan tempted Jesus. Everybody, Luke, Gospel of Luke.
1 hour later.
6 months later.
Yes.
2,000 years later.
Gospel of Luke chapter 4 verse 1 to 13. He will read that, and it came to pass. And Jesus being full of the Holy Ghost came from Jerusalem and led by the Spirit unto the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. In those days he did. So says that he was full of Holy Spirit and Satan was tempting him to sin. So we know that are three temptations of Jesus. Now we'll not going to brief everything, we will get to overlook of that. We will get to overlook of two things. First temptation. So first we know that it is written in the verse 3 and 4. He says that turn the stone into bread and eat it. It is a lust of flesh. It means he says something related to flesh. He is saying that turn this stone into bread and eat it. It means lust of flesh. The same thing he is using. Lust of flesh. But what did Jesus answer? The man shall not live by bread alone, but he shall live by every word of God out of his mouth. So we know that this is this is the way he answered Satan. So he is using the word to defend this sin. He is using the word to defend the Satan and any temptation. And now we second temptation is still in chapter verse 5 to 8. now he shows him the every kingdom of this world. He shows him that there are these many kingdoms. Now he's showing them, see it and worship me. If you worship me, I will give this thing to you. It means he is showing him. It means lust of eyes. He is showing to Jesus. It means trying to deceive by lust of eyes. But what did Jesus answer? Worship God alone. It means he said that if you worship me, I will give everything which is pleasing to your eyes. He is showing. It is lust of eyes. What Jesus said, it is written. It is written in the word. You shall worship only your God. And third thing is that Satan took Jesus to the pinnacle of the temple and said, now just jump from the temple, and the angels will come and hold you, because it is written angels will angels will not leave you to even like into the stone. You don't know that verse. Here the pride of life. It means Jesus like to tempting God, or is he using those things that angels will come and protect him? He is trying to use this spiritual protection. It means it is a pride of life, and what Jesus answered? He answered, "You shall not tempt your Lord God." Simple. Satan used the same tricks which he used to trick Adam and Eve. He used the same trick even to the Jesus. So that same three source of sin: lust of flesh, lust of eyes, pride of life. But Jesus answered them through the word. He was very strong. He was very strong in the foundation of word of God. So he can answer Satan with the word of God. As we saw, the first was the turning stone into bread, lust of flesh, and second was showing him every kingdom of God, lust of eyes, and third was tempting God by getting jump of the temple and making angels to come. It's a pride of life. So we saw that Satan uses these same things to resist Adam and also to resist Jesus, and he will use this all three same thing to even deceive you. So now, how are we going to define it? In the same way Jesus defined it, by the word of God. So the whole conclusion is that we have to be very strong in the word of God. We have to read the Bible daily. We have to be strong. We have to be strong and founded in the word of God very, very toughly, very strongly, so that the Satan doesn't deceive us. This is the conclusion. We have to read the Bible daily. Yeah, thank you for something learned from the video. Like the video and share the video to your friends, and subscribe to our channel, the Light of Truth, and tap the bell icon. Thank you until I meet you in the next video. Bye. Thank you. God bless you.